Hello, everybody. Abam here, and I'm welcoming you to Ghostbusters today in honor of Halloween and the greatest franchise that ever existed. We are going to play Ghostbusters video game remastered. Let's get into it. In your neighborhood,
who you gonna call? Ghostbusters! Are you troubled by strange noises in the night?
Do you experience feelings of dread in your basement or attic?
Have you or your family actually seen a spook, specter, or ghost?
If the answer is yes, then don't wait another minute. Just pick up the phone and call the professional.
Call the Ghostbusters. We're ready to believe you.
Franchises available soon. Call for details.
Whoa! Russell! Hey, man!
You near the East Wing?
Yep.
By the new Ghoster exhibit?
Yeah, why?
There's something headed your way.
Wait.
I hear something.
I'm gonna take a look.
Wanna hear something really creepy? I was reading about Shandor, you know, the guy who donated most of the Gozer stuff. He was into the occult.
Evo Shandor.
You know, supernatural. Weird dude.
Why don't we talk about it some other time? Any other time.
Hey, you can't be in here. Stop!
We do not summon dead family members, then catch them so you can ask the combination to the safe. Yeah, well, same to you, pal.
Hey, it's the new cadet! Welcome aboard!
This Thank might you. Be a little dangerous.
Great. Danger is our life.
We'll start at 50% capacity. That should keep any burning or tissue damage to a minimum.
Hey, if you're gonna burn any tissue, do it to the new kid. You can't use Ray. Our mortgage is in his name.
I guess he's right. What's your name again, kid?
No names, Ray. I don't want to get too attached to this kid. You know, just in case. You remember what happened to the last guy?
What happened to the last guy?
He's tuned and ready to go.
You may feel a little tingle. Good. We've perfected an extensive and rigorous training regimen that will teach you all your equipment's basic functions.
It takes some time to achieve master throw skill, but it's definitely worth the effort.
Whoa! Was that us?
I don't think so.
Ray?
Had to be some sort of psi energy pulse. Substantial. A significant collected and centralized necromantic convulsion, level 7 or more.
Agreed. We need EMF measurement checks now.
Onionhead.
I know the answer, but I'm going to ask anyway. Is a level 7, whatever, bad or very bad?
On a scale of 1 to 10, I would say...
Let me guess. It's a 7.
Let's just say we're about to get real busy.
And that is not the fun kind of getting busy. Is it, Ray?
Look out! Slimer's escaped again!
No.
Well,
way.
Of course he has. All right. Take a look around. This is the perfect season to strap on proton packs and go to work. Let's do it. Right down the pole with the pack on. Perfect. Stop to get a drink. Gotta stay hydrated. Stay sharp. Make good decisions.
There it is. It seems oddly drawn to the containment grid.
He's been fascinated with it ever since you added the viewer to the unit. Okay, easy now, cadet. I'll talk you through this. Use the proton stream to get his attention.
All right.
That's some highly sensitive equipment you're disintegrating there, kid. Oops, you let one out.
That's my fault.
Ooh.
I was fine-tuning the interspatial gasket this afternoon. I'll fix it. You two get those ghosts back.
You got it.
Hey, this'll work out great since you're already strapped into a pack. It's a perfect opportunity for some training. Taking the right precautions, Slimer's harmless. More or less. Not sure about the other guy, though. Okay, let's go get him, then.
All right, let's go.
Oh, and don't sweat the containment unit. It's easy to get excited your first time out with a proton stream. Egon will fix it in no time.
Yeah, man, I strapped the pack on. I'm ready to go.
Now, first and foremost, before things get out of hand, you want to get to know your proton pack. It can be your best friend out there in the field. Everything you need to know is displayed on the pack itself. Here's where you keep an eye on your current physical condition. The more green that's on the bar, the more damage you can sustain and still stay on your feet. This bar indicates your pack's heat level. When it gets to the top, you'll want to vent the pack and keep it from shorting out and resetting. For the most part, capturing a ghost is pretty straightforward. We break it into three basic steps. Sap them, cap them, and trap them. The first step is blasting a ghost to sap its energy.
Listen to that power up.
You're a wicked shot, newbie! See that overlay on the ghost? It indicates the current accumulation of a ghost's PKE. The more you disperse, the weaker it becomes.
We don't want to cross the stream, Trey. Ouch. I don't want to damage too many things, you know.
Pack's moving into the red, Cadet Bennett.
Gotta watch. Don't want your pack to overheat. That was you, Ray. You destroyed those boxes. I'm trying not to make a lot of property damage here. Oop. I think I took out one of the support beams for our sub-basement.
Ooh, we lost Slimer. There it is! Ugh, and I thought Slimer was disgusting.
What do we have here? So this is the Sloth Ghost. He's a Class 5 full roaming cardinal. We have to trap him. He has a ranged attack. His weakness is to a proton stream. The Sedgwick Hotel traditionally auctioned off a family Thanksgiving feast and donated the proceeds to charity, usually the St. Nicholas Rehabilitation Mission for Wayward Angels. In 1937, Arbison Morguncher, a wealthy but lonely Epicurean, bid upon and won the feast. On Thanksgiving Day, he arrived to dine alone. The Sedgwick's manager protested that the feast was intended for more than 12 people, but Morguncher insisted that he be fed the entire meal. The manager shrugged and finally relented. Morguncher sat down and ate the entire meal, leaving not a crumb. "My compliments to the chef," he said, 7 hours later. Swallowing the last bite, he died from a gastric rupture due to massive overeating. Authorities later found a suicide note at Morguncher's home outlining that he intended to die while indulging his greatest fantasy. Well, let's put this weirdo back in the container. Oh! Oh no! We got you. Sorry, my bad. I'm trying to hide here. Alright.
You've got it good and winded. Next stage, cap. You can project the capture stream or wrangler manually using this control. On the other hand, the pack will detect when a ghost is sufficiently weakened and auto select the capture stream setting. Get in there and throw a capture stream on that tub of goo.
Got him.
Watch the ghost. When he makes a dash in one direction, you pull the speed. Give it a shot. Good work.
Looks like it still has some fight left in it. If a ghost still has some serious fight in it, possible to drag him into the trap. Try to soften him up. Pow! That's right. Now we can move to stage three.
Trap. There we go.
You're going to need some place to put that. Throw out your trap.
Let's
right.
go.
See the beacon signal coming? Trap draws down different ghosts at different rates. But they all flush the same in the end.
Very nice, Cadet. You've got some real promise.
One in the box. Ready to go. We be fast, and he be slow.
Did you get them?
We're batting 500. Slimer slipped out. Our cadet bagged his first one, though. A very nasty customer. Oh, and you've got to be very careful about crossing the streams. In a word, don't do it.
Seriously.
Got it.
Stings like the dickens, too.
Hey, how come this mump gets all the new stuff?
He's our new experimental equipment technician.
He gets a cool title, too?
It means he gets to carry around a bunch of untested,
I
extremely
earned it.
Dangerous hardware that, if not handled correctly, could blow him somewhere into New Jersey.
Oh, this knucklehead lugs around our very dangerous prototype hardware that could potentially blow us into New Jersey. Thanks. Keep the title, kid. It'll work hard for you.
Thanks.
Scooter, we need to go. Let's roll.
All right, let's take a look at the firehouse while we're here. We got Vigo.
Such a pity victory in the face of the vast pool of chaos.
Hello, Ghostbusters.
Rising around you.
Just one moment.
Got Janine.
I'm looking up your file.
Venkman's desk.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that's the correct setup, but all right. There's the Ghostbusters 2 sign that actually is in the firehouse in New York.
I can schedule an appointment.
That's all right. I don't have a locker yet.
All right. Thank you.
There's Lewis's flight suit and his desk. What's he got? Feeling sick, going home early. Okay. Well, it's all right, Lewis. It's all right, Lewis. Hey, Seabury, welcome to the chat. Look around up here. If you look at this screen, congratulations, you have completed a great game. This here came from the end credits of the original Ghostbusters game for the NES. Got Q-Bert. Yep, that's about right. Well, let's take the... We're ready to roll. You gotta try this pole.
Where to, Ray?
The Sedgwick Hotel. That's the first place that little spud will go.
Right.
It's true.
Back to its initial manifestation point.
They've got a real good buffet.
It is a great one. When Winston returns from the opera, extend an invitation to join us at our table at the Sedgwick. Hey, you. You're up, buddy. Training will be on the job tonight. Try not to destroy too many Manhattan landmarks. That's our job.
Here we go. Good park job. The Sedgwick Hotel was actually the Biltmore in Los Angeles. Greatest franchise ever.
Disgusting green blob is up on the 12th floor again, wreaking havoc. I demand a refund right now.
Sir, if you check the fine print on our invoice...
Invoices.
Right, invoices. You'll see that your warranty on rehaunting expired some time ago. You should have taken the extended service agreement.
Always take the extended service agreement.
I'm getting some interesting PKE spikes here. Disturbances don't seem to be exclusive to the 12th floor. I'd like the chance to look around the building a little more.
Good.
Let's get a little drink here. Can.
That little greenie shouldn't cause us too much trouble.
Check out the hotel. We got a luggage check, coat check. Looks like this goes to behind the front desk here. You can get cold drinks and crispy snacks. They're real crispy. All right, we got the, oh, it's the Rodriguez Bar Mitzvah here. Nice job. Excellent. Looks real good, man. Looking real good.
Look, it's them.
Yep. We're the Ghostbusters.
Hey, Ghostbusters.
Yep. Oops, sorry. Oh. Oh, should have practiced.
Do you have a reservation with us this evening?
No, I'm just doing my work.
We're really looking forward to this trip.
I'm afraid
really
we're fully booked, sir.
Yeah, we're gonna try
to. Welcome to the Sedgwick. Do you have a reservation with me?
It's been sold out for months, but Harv got tickets to his office.
That's lucky.
Right? Yeah. Then we're gonna see the state.
Everything looks good over here, guys. Let's push in a little bit.
Well, hello. You're perfectly safe now, Miss. The Ghostbusters are here.
Back off, loser. Never gonna
happen. Come on, Bankman.
That approach rarely works with me. I'll show you why later.
Oh, Venky, Venky, Venky.
All right, Ace. Get ready.
Dr. Stance? If you'd do the honors.
Proud to, Dr. Venkman.
Part of our settlement with the city, proton packs must remain off in heavily populated.
I love that sound.
And in close quarters. It minimizes the city's liabilities and satisfies the restraining order the maid here had put on us.
Where we live in today, you shoot a proton stream of highly charged particles at someone, they get all so happy. It's him!
No. Not again.
Nice. Now we got another plaintiff. Oh, come on, Ray. I'm the one that gets a face full of slime every time the little green buddy escapes. He doesn't even know me well enough to hate me.
Watch it!
Uh-huh.
Contact! Ah, yow! Jeez!
Everybody all right?
We're burning daylight, Pilgrim. Can we get out of here?
All right, showtime.
There he is. Out,
then we capture him. That's what your proton stream is for.
We've got him on the run! Come on, let's go! Peter!
Nah, I've seen this one already. Know how it ends. You two have fun, though. I'll cover the elevators and escort any ladies safely to their rooms.
Yeah.
Great job, okay. Dr. Bankman.
And this signal looks just like your elusive little targeted entity. Your meter will flash and buzz when it detects a potential signal. The pair of goggles are linked directly to your active PKE meter. This lets you see otherwise undetectable phenomena while you track it. Ghost trails, object auras, all kinds of cool events. Now, when the center bar peaks, you're headed in the right direction. When it's flat, you're following a cold trail. Line
well,
the target
check
up
this
with the
out,
smallest
then.
Circle for the best scan. Okay, you way to go!
What did we scan here? Class 1 supernatural secretion. A thick, slimy substance, ectoplasm is formed when ghosts interact with the physical world, usually seen as a viscous, mucus-like slime. Ectoplasm has also been encountered in mist-like and even crystalline forms. All right.
Red signifies a hidden ghost. Green indicates an environmental paranormal anomaly. Blue means an active sample.
I got something this way, Dr. Stance.
Getting warmer.
Looks like it's gonna be here.
Getting a good scan is sort of like taking a good snapshot. When you've got an entity in range, hold the scan button. This will analyze the ghost's PKE signatures and shuffle.
So we can already purchase an upgrade. Let's see. What money do we have? Well, we're just going to do this right now. All right, so we got blast stream focusing. Oh, we have a... I think there's a haunted tray around here.
Whoa!
A haunted room service tray. There it is.
An active sample is something you can...
Circa 1893, fine silver service set purchased as a lot from the famed Austrian Hotel de Gustave after it mysteriously burned down. This is the only piece from the set known to appear at the Sedgwick rooms, unbidden and unaccompanied. Frightened guests are often unsure as to the proper gratuity for this service.
Collect, like a cursed artifact.
A nice
artifact.
Little flower and everything.
We get paid extra for everything we scan and collect. Then we roll it back into research and development. The extra funds let us experiment with new equipment and offensive technologies, which
sounds
in turn,
right.
You get to wear on your back to test. Remember,
very
you can always review techniques, tutorials, and equipment in your online Ghostbusters field manual. It's all accessible from your PKE meter.
You got it.
I don't feel good!
Peter, come in. You okay? Uh-oh, man down.
Let's go.
We've got a man down. Go, go, go! Come on, shake a leg. You can move faster than that, can't you? Double time, cadet.
I'm moving faster than you.
He's been slimed again. Hustle over here.
I got
and help
you.
Him up, will you?
How did this even happen? I was covering the elevators.
Well, you know.
The mutant Stromboli snuck up on me. Funked the fire again.
When one of us goes down, we always help each other out. It's all about teamwork.
Oh, no, my friend.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
In the pre-sliming era. Right now, it's all about payback.
You guys need to get down here immediately. Our live-in science experiment is tearing apart the lobby, and he's not alone.
More ghosts? But we gave this hotel a clean bill of health 5 years ago.
New people die every day.
Call the elevator, Junior.
You've got it. Let's go.
All right, Slimer. You've had your fun. The elevator's off limits. Egon, come in. I think we're stuck in the elevator. We need some help.
Think we're stuck. Well, let's see. Think we're stuck. Think we're stuck. Think we're stuck. Ray, you guys good with officially stuck in the elevators? Show of hands.
Put your hands up. Yep, we're good with this.
Here it comes.
Kill it, Ray!
Need a hand?
Thanks, Egon.
You always fail me, Ray, don't you?
Uh-oh. Well, it looks like we
never
got
mind
some...
the onion head for now. Ghost with the red cap is fighting hard to hold stasis.
Come on. He's a New York bellhop. Just get him, will you?
Got some Bellman ghosts here. You guys handle that for a minute.
Whites on their eyes, kid.
Aim high.
It's on your left.
I'm all right.
You
gotta worry.
Just 1 second.
I'm down. Everybody's down.
Look behind you. Make a hole. Ah! Oh!
There it is. What did we find? Let's take a look. Origin unknown, but reportedly seen in the Hotel des Jardins Prytaniers just before its disappearance. The hotel, not the bell. How this paranormally significant artifact ended up in the Hotel Sedgwick is anyone's guess, though its impact on customer service cannot be underestimated. It's true. Gotta have a good bell. All right, now we got work to do. Let's go.
Ow! That was ow there.
Well, get out of the way, then. Looks like we're making enough room for traps here.
A little help. Yo, a little help.
Look out, on your left.
Thankman?
On the right. Oh. Whoa, look at him. Got a piece of that one.
Throwing chairs, are ya?
You've got him on the rope.
Let's get this guy trapped, shall we? One down.
Look behind you. Hey, I'm on your side.
Well, don't stand there then. Don't forget to pick up your traps, guys.
Crossing streams was a very bad idea.
You own that creep.
Bring him over here. Ooh.
Ow! Now yours! Ooh, man, that stings!
Get him in the trap.
Whoa!
Perfect.
A convulsive PK shockwave really stirred the nest. Man,
always pick up your
so
trap.
Wrecked.
Can we please call Winston and tell him his night off is officially ended?
Looks like we got some more.
Four of them!
That's trouble.
It's on your left. Ow!
No.
Follow me. The others are floating back upstairs. Venkman, you two pull our friend Slimer into a trap as fast as you can. There's a massive bulge in these spikes indicating this isn't just some routine clearing job.
He gets so bossy when he hasn't had his nap.
It's true.
Hey now, is that honey glazed ham and prime rib?
There, the Alhambra Ballroom. No way he could pass that up.
Absolutely not! You can't go in. The Rodriguez Bar Mitzvah is set to start in half an hour.
I'll bet the beef brisket is today's special.
And you've done quite enough
already.
We have
work to do.
I'm sure the thing will just go away. I'm willing to risk it. You're not going in there.
That's all we needed to hear. All right, we're out. Coffee time, everyone. Service has been declined beyond this point.
Sounds like the Alhambra's off limits.
Oh, the schmutz,
you say. Nobody slimes Pete Bankman twice.
Ectoplasmic residue left behind.
Careful, Peter. Remember the Ellis Island incident?
You bring your apron? We're going to take a little shortcut through the kitchen.
Take a look at this hotel kitchen, then.
The Alhambra should be right through here. Hello, chef.
They could,
okay.
Do a little cleaning up in
Champion.
Here.
Champion, you lead for a while.
Always lift with your legs, never with your back. What do you think?
You should be ashamed of yourselves. Shut the place down.
All right.
All right, don't touch the slime. It's slimy and it's extremely dangerous.
What do we have here? A class one caustic seep. Black slime is encountered in locations of intersection between the real and the ghost worlds. It is a dangerous substance formed of ectoplasm supersaturated with negative energy. Black slime is incredibly caustic and will cause severe damage to anyone heedless enough to come into contact with it. Based on its spectral resonance echo, black slime also appears to function as a conduit for PKE energy. That's gonna come in to play later on. Yes,
think I'd be used to that stuff by now.
Venkman did want to make sure that we might not be disturbing the chef and their staff. What do we have here? Just left out. Something happened. Everybody left. Those shrimp are overcooked. And, I don't know.
Nothing to worry about. Most kitchens have self-starting pilot lights.
Something's up. What was that? Pappy Sargassy, huh?
Okay, I dare you. Everything but the kitchen sink.
All right, let's see what we scanned here. Class 1, inhabiting swarmer. It's corporeal. These minor spirits seem to be subservient to a greater entity's will and have been driven to protect it by possessing and controlling a variety of fish market cast-offs. Like other Class 1 swarmers, dead fish flyers are quick-moving but fairly weak creatures that, once disrupted, quickly fade back into the depths of the ghost world. And Pappy Sargassy here. He's a Class 3 roaming animator. Descending from a long, proud line of seafarers and fishermen, Pappy Sargassy attempted to avoid the notoriously unlucky early deaths on the water that plagued his family by pursuing a more landlocked career. In 1950, he opened a restaurant, Sargassy's, and attempted to turn his back on the sea. In later years, he overcame his fear of the water and took up fishing. His family curse caught up with him, or he was the unluckiest fisherman who ever lived, and he died choking on a fish stick while being eaten by a great white shark. That just sounds terrible. I'd be a little upset myself. Get rid of this and get rid of some of these ghosts. We can grab another upgrade, I believe. Make some money here. Wires out of the way. Oh! Still got some more of them, eh? All right.
This is why I ate out of the can.
Fair. We're doing a little bit of damage here. But let's see, So we have... What do we have? $7,300 right now? We'll grab a fast trap. Leaves us with $2,300. Always got to have good equipment. I don't know why you'd have a lot of space in this kitchen. But really, they could use a good cleanup. And that is unsafe. Come on, who leaves the knife in the cheese? No, somebody's going to get hurt.
All right, check this out. The trap, you've
all right, let's
grab
get this out of the way.
You use the other hand to take protection. That's all there is to it. You just throw this junk anywhere. We don't stick around and clean it.
We're going to move it over here. There you go. Yeah, oof. Wow, that's dangerous looking. Take a look around. Oh, we gotta stay puffed here. A little squeak. Circa 1989, a Ghostbusters craze broke throughout New York City following the Vigo incident of 89. Souvenir street vendors moved literal tons of unlicensed clothing and cheap knockoff novelties. It's estimated that Stay Puft figures outsold the usually best-selling Statue of Liberty by more than 2-1 that year, even the new wind-up walking version of Libby. The trend faded almost as quickly as it began, and sales of Ghostbusters merchandise dwindled. Some remainders can still be found on the streets of Manhattan and the boroughs, and may even be imbued with supernatural elements. Mine doesn't do anything. All right. When I was a... Now, who put that there? Something. They really gotta clean up around here, honestly. All right.
I thought that guy said Rodriguez Bar Mitzvah.
He did. He did say Rodriguez Bar Mitzvah. Onion head.
Would it kill him to mix in a green salad once in a while? I'm going to take back, blast him until he's dazed, and then throw your capture stream on him.
You got it. That's all right. Venkman, watch my back. There it is. What do we get here? An old suitcase? Circa 1865, the Voyage in Case Internationale has been appearing at train stations, loading docks, and airports since the mid-1800s. Porters and baggage handlers around the globe whisper its legend, generally regarded as friendly. All right. No issue there.
Ow! That was ow there!
We gotta talk to the chef here. If this is a bar mitzvah, why is there a ham on it? Up. It's all right.
Good, good. That's it, buddy. You've got the little monster breathing hard.
All right, let's find him. Dr. Venkman, I think we made a little bit of a mess. Got him, Dr. Franklin.
Try to hold him still. You gotta wear him down. When he's tired, you'll be able to put his sorry crater of a butt into the trap. All right, trap's in. You're almost there. Guide him in.
Oh, he ran again. I think he's here. Might be UKE meter does not seem to be working well enough. Get him. Get the trap out. There we go.
Perfect. See? That's a big wow. That'll teach that pitiful goop sack to slime, Pete Venkman. And by extension, you. Perhaps a place sitting disturbed. Still pretty much ready. Full go for the Rodriguez blowout.
The Alhambra.
Seems
bar.
Right.
The bar mitzvah. What have you done? The guests are arriving in 15 minutes.
What?
Look, the food is fine. Just
problem.
Pull some storage from
Thanks
tables and
to
whatnot.
Me
and
my
you'll
new
be fine.
Exclusively
no issues.
Assigned recruit here, the festivities can now proceed in an entirely ghost-free environment. So, you're welcome, huh? And to the Rodriguez, L'chaim from the Ghostbusters.
Indeed. You'll be fine, bud. I mean, really, it's not that bad. Just a couple tables, a little replacement of the dance floor.
This is terrible.
I guess some of the work behind the bar, but hey. That's where,
Why is this
Slimer went into the ballroom. Looking good.
Nice of you guys to join us. You grabbed the little spud?
Ray.
Yeah, I got him in my trap.
Hard to blob talk with this one. We are going to have this much.
Well, looks like we still got some,
Heads up, your initiation is over. Now give us a hand. We've got a couple of really persistent troublesome spirits here.
It's all right. Peter?
Swarm.
Yeah, there's quite a few of them.
That was ow there.
Let's see what they say about the bellhop ghost here. While all grand old hotels have their dark secrets, the elegant Sedgwick Hotel has them all trumped. Ever since it opened in 1897, the Sedgwick has exuded an eerie atmosphere. An inordinate number of guests and staff have met untimely ends due to strange accidents and sometimes foul play. Most of them stay forever, drawn to an inexorable force that traps them in the Sedgwick's many corridors, suites, ballrooms, and service areas. The spectral staff takes great care of the hotel and don't appreciate disturbances other than the ones they create themselves. Take a look at what we say about Slimer. He's a class 5 full roaming vapor, as we all know. Sometimes called Onion Head or simply the Mean Green Ghost. Ray purportedly named this creature Slimer specifically to annoy Peter, who still carries a long-standing distrust of the creature. Regardless of what he's called, this focused non-terminal repeating phantasm personifies gluttony and is drawn to anything edible. While this class 5 full roaming vapor isn't especially malicious, you don't want to be between him and a snack. Use caution when he's hungry, which is all the time. So, Onion Head was in tribute to the late, great John Belushi, who was supposed to star in Ghostbusters before his unfortunate death. Rest in peace. Alright, now back to the good time.
Crossing is a strict no-no.
I know, we don't want to cross the streams.
It's on your left.
I got knocked down. Help me up. Thank you.
Hey, run.
Ray, you alright?
Aim high. That's trouble.
Jump out of the way.
Careful, we almost crossed the stream.
We don't want to cross the stream. Crossing the streams is bad.
It's okay, I'm
wow. Here. Quick knockdown.
Hey, look, it's toxic.
They are definitely swarming. We'll be able to take one down soon. I want to get to that one there.
Here they come. On your left.
Watch out, they throw things. Oh, this hotel is going to piss at us, let me tell you.
You're flirting with total platonic
nice. There we go.
Getting the hang of it. Good trap work.
Get it in there. Good. Throwing out a trap.
Almost there. Hey, I'm on your side. Well done. Aim high. You don't want to cross the streams. I'm speaking from experience.
Trap out.
Ow!
Good, we got him.
Such a chore now, was it?
Oof. Yeah. Not good.
Who's going to pay for all of this?
No need to worry, sir. As you know, the mayor rode to office on a strictly pro-Ghostbusters platform. And we now invoice the city directly for all captures and eliminations. And unhaunted New York is a tourist-friendly New York.
No. But damage.
The mayor and the city have taken out an extensive insurance policy as well, so you're covered.
Honestly, I'm sensing some hostility here. Perhaps we should just leave the ghosts here, if that's what you would prefer, sir.
No! No. But please, be discreet.
Discretion is our professional motto.
Heads up!
Uh-oh. Pappy Sargassi.
Where did he come from?
I suppose we should go after him, unless you want to discuss it first.
Cadet, go with Dr. Spengler. Check out the angry fisherman.
All right, Dr. Spengler, let's go.
This way. Looks like he's drifting upstairs. Get across there. Move. Take the lead. Take this trap.
You got it. All right, Dr. Spengler. I'll see you on the other side. Not going that way. But we do have to check up here. Because that's not right. Circa 1910, when Godfrey McAllister Sedgwick opened his grand hotel, many thought it strange that someone who detested people so thoroughly would open a business where so many were invited to come. Interesting. I'm okay.
Hey, is there a bathtub overflowing up there?
More specifically, a 7,000 cubic meter bathtub filled with profoundly
charged
seawater. Not
quite. We got a lot of water, though.
And, sea cucumbers?
All right, we handle this kind of thing all the time.
Manifestation point.
Thanks for letting me know now. I mean, I am a professional. I already had an idea. It's a class 2 vermin imprinter. It's corporeal. Candelabrum crawlers are powered by swarming little vermin spirits who animate seemingly innocent light fixtures and turn them to sinister purpose. These spirits, primarily the imprint of an animal life force that once existed in our physical world, take over simple objects and then force them into a rough copy of their original physical form. Alright, so we've got spider candelabras. Terrifying. Engineering is going to have a lot of work to do. Careful, I don't have any help here. We're looking okay.
Thank you.
City attack. There he is. Well, that drains that a little bit. Let's have a drink here. Ah, yes. Good old assies. Come on. Come on, you dirty old fisherman. Let's go. Ooh. Where's he at? Thought I could stop that one. Heal up here.
Good work. Are you all right?
Nice going. You might really be the right person for this job.
Yes, you have destroyed a significant section of a 5-star New York hotel in just under 3 hours. Your mother and I are so proud. Aren't we, Egon?
He's got something. Let's track it down.
So it looks like the kitchen that we were in earlier downstairs just dealt with the banquet hall. Oh boy. So that is a kitchen golem. It's a class 6 bi-dimensional attractor. Golems can bend objects to their will, manipulating them to form portions of their own physically manifested form. PK energy greatly grants the golem the ability to reconstitute damaged or destroyed portions of its body. The golem was formed from paranormally comprised items from the kitchen of a restaurant located in the Hotel Sedgwick. Well, we better take it down quickly.
It's some type of highly focused anthropomorphic animator. An entity which attracts familiar objects to itself so it can materially manifest its rage.
Whoa! Don't get hit. I got hit.
So strong that it's able to reassemble its component parts.
It's a nice, reasonably sized restaurant for the hotel. As I'm getting thrown across the room. We're all being tossed around. You gotta get that piece on its head there.
Watching streams are crossing.
Yeah, I know.
It's losing strength. Keep tearing it
there
down.
We go. I don't want that. Be able to,
Keep your shirt on.
All right.
Somebody will show up.
Somebody help me
right.
up.
It's on your left.
Man, he is aggressive.
Look behind you.
I'm okay. Thank you.
You gotta try everything.
but not this.
You've got him on the ropes!
All right, now
can't
we
get
can
out of there.
Pull that off there, and Sargassi is back. We got him. Trap's going out. Ooh. Maybe I should be a part of this, huh?
Ooh! You got him!
On the right!
Hold him out!
Put him in the trap. Come on, guys. There we go.
At me, but when knives and forks become a big angry giant, that's really me not liking it a lot.
Happens every day, right?
It does.
Anybody here from Zetamore?
Guys, I'm right outside, and so is something else.
Gosh, we've missed you, partner. Glad you could make it. But first, how was Aida? Well, we had to.
Traffic is a little.
Wait. I know that thud.
Winston, what do you see out there?
It's big. It's clean and soft and white. And you all aren't gonna like it.
It's Stay Puft.
No, this is not possible. Not here, not now, not again! Wasn't me this time, I swear it.
Pull it together, Ray. What do we have that can stop that cheap gun?
Ray, weren't you gonna finish up the install of the Super Slammer today?
The Super Slammer? Sounds untested. Tacky and exciting. I'm in. But will it work?
Against the minions of a god? That was never the intent. But in theory, I suppose it could. But a Muon trap of this capacity has never been used or even tried before.
Uh-huh. And why would that stop guys that don't know anybody?
Yeah, man. What are we? The FDA?
We'll have to clear a path through this mess first.
Well, that's where we're going to end the episode for today. We are into Ghostbusters now. We have cleared out the Sedgwick Hotel, albeit for some property damage, but, you know, that's covered. We're the Ghostbusters. We're professionals. We handle this kind of thing all the time. Next time we come back, we are going to chase after Stay Puft and see what's going on. Thank you all for joining me today for this episode. If you haven't already, consider subscribing on YouTube, leaving a like, and commenting on the video. Follow me on Twitch. Thank you so much for all the support. I can't do it without it. Thank you for everything. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time. We're on.